For decades, Democrats were some of the worst at gerrymandering. They used packing and cracking to give their leaders easy wins, who would be leaders just out of seniority, and reduce representation of their opponents. Each Democratic state had probably one, or in that rare case, two more representatives than they should have had in Congress, giving them more political advantage and making them much less likely to care about what their people actually wanted. Now, don't think for a second that Republicans were saints. They were just as bad in states they ran, but after the Great Depression, people were just loyal to Democrats longer, and they were able to use gerrymandering to lock in their majorities for decades. It wasn't until around the 2000 redistricting that both parties were on equal footing in gerrymandering. And then the 2010 election happened, and gerrymandering became worse than ever before. Using new GIS technology, Republican state houses figured out the most efficient way to gerrymander, giving two states three extra seats compared to percentage of the votes, and three states two extra seats using a strategy labeled Red Map. This year, the Supreme Court, even when given a completely math-based system to prove that gerrymandering did not represent the people, thanks to the addition of Gorsuch and Kavanaugh, decided that no gerrymandering case, except in the case of racial discrimination, can ever be brought before the Supreme Court again. The Supreme Court, which could have ended this blatant damage to representation and helped create more partisan politics, decided status quo, even in the face of all evidence, was just fine. So, what do we do now? Well, in some cases, ballot initiatives are working. All the West Coast states have some method of gerrymandering restriction. In 2018, four states, including Michigan, with two extra House seats, all passed ballot measures to reduce or check gerrymandering in some way, though they won't come into effect until the 2022 election. However, less than half of the states have ballot initiatives. In Pennsylvania, where there are three extra seats for the GOP until last year, the state Supreme Court struck it down and forced new maps to be redrawn because of a clause in the Pennsylvania state constitution. Around half of all states have similar clauses that anti-gerrymandering groups are hoping to take to court state by state, but they will all come down to their state Supreme Courts. The best step, in my opinion, is for Democratic states who don't gerrymander or don't use GIS to do it, to threaten to blue map to counter the red map so it nullifies all the congressional advantages of red mapping. If they did that, they could agree to hold a bi or multi-state agreement not to gerrymander if the other side doesn't. This would effectively blunt most gerrymandering in the states. However, that would require Democratic states to step up and threaten to do what Republicans are doing, fighting fire with fire. How well this will turn out and the chances of it happening, who knows, not very. And legislators on the state level will still have heavy gerrymandering for decades to come, but it could blunt the extreme partisanship on the national level. So thank you so much for joining me on my podcast. I'm sure there was nothing controversial about this, and everyone will happily get along in the comments section, which you can do on the YouTube version of this video, link in the show notes. Just a reminder that I'm Anubis2814 on YouTube, and I have over 500 videos on different topics that I've made over the past 10 years. Please subscribe, and if your podcast site has the option, give me a like or review. If you think what I have to say informed you, consider supporting my Patreon. I'll be doing this podcast weekly and try to get it out on the same day, so I hope to see you here next week, ready to be filled with new ideas. Take care. A big thank you goes out to Elias Garcia Guevara and Joe Taylor, who sponsor the show at $10 a month at the Wapawet level on Patreon. Please consider donating as well if you can, and thank you all for listening.